depending on how you look at it. Today,
So right.
So right.
So very right.
Today will be, our kobolds will be attempting to complete their mission in the human town of Vandalin.
Oh boy!
Where, you know, kobolds are loved and appreciated, or not. So this will be interesting to see how they continue on forward.
Okay, so here's my plan. I say we go up to the... No, wait. How about...
we cut in with our kobolds going back to the wagon.
Where did you come from?
What? What do you mean? I've been here the whole time.
Oh, yes.
I mean, I fell behind a little bit because you guys left me to be eaten by wolves, but I got out of there. I think this guy was there, too.
Oh, yeah, not you. Where did you? Where did you come from?
Ah, what happened?
You notice a small contingent of kobolds has rejoined.
Ah, reinforcements.
Yeah, yeah.
Hello, everybody.
We kind of look at each other and go, okay, let's see who's who.
I am Marv, the Undying, Quartermaster and Keeper of the Prince, boy.
I am Jobes.
I don't believe you.
He doesn't have a title yet. He's been trying to work on it, but he's been... He's
so far, I just guys. Carried stuff.
Hey, now he's swatted. He's come up to your father and killed his father. I am Dr. Royal Physician Baldur the Flaminator. Don't shut up.
I'm Lugi, the wolf killer.
He kills one wolf and takes the title. He doesn't even wear the skin. Of course, we were swimming away trying not to get eaten by wolves.
So you've noticed there's been a small contingent of kobolds rejoining the group, bringing your numbers back up to 20. Just to the proper amount in which you'll get paid for it.
How about we set the town on fire, and when they all run away from the town so they all burn to death horribly and painfully and be eaten by kobolds, then we go in.
Because we don't get paid if we burn the town.
Remember, we have to get all the money. All the gold.
They probably burn. Leave the money to be taken.
They gotta pillage, then burn. Don't they?
Okay, so... But the villagers, they aren't gonna want to see us, right?
There's one thing I know about humanins. They love their gold more than their lives. So they'll take it with them.
So you know stuff, huh?
Pew stands around for a moment and goes, Marv, I'm leaving you in charge of this contingency. I have to make my way back and take care of some unfinished business.
I understand.
And he begins to skate off.
I'm the keeper of the... No one.
Okay, bye, current prince. Hopefully you don't die today.
I have lost my title.
No, you're still the keeper of the prince. You just keep him far away.
You know, a while back, I was thinking... Boy, I hope it's my turn to be the prince soon. But then the princess kept dying. And I'm like, you know what? That's okay.
Well, none of us are now.
Oh, yeah. We better choose a prince so we know who dies next, huh?
Oh, he just told me I was in charge, boy.
Oh, so you're the prince and so you're going to die next, okay?
No, he's the keeper of the prince. Dig the taters out of your ears, Pilgrim.
What are you talking about? I'm a kobold. I don't have surface ears. I have tympanic membranes. See that? It's perfectly flat.
Yeah, boy.
You're a weird one. I don't know what that accent is.
There's a lot you don't know, Pilgrim.
Yeah, I don't know why you're still here. So there's that. That's a good part of it.
Well, you guys continue arguing. The other kobolds seem to start getting the wagon ready.
Oh, yeah, we got those guys. Alright, so we don't sack the whole village. That's bad. Right?
Right, so one of us should go in and find this person that we're supposed to give this cart to.
I think it was the dwarf guy, though. The dwarf guy said...
He's the one that... He got captured and taken away by goblins, and then we didn't find him.
The guy who was in charge of what we was going to do, he dead. And the guy that replaced him is dead. And I think one more. Was anybody keeping any kind of notes? Now we hate the written language. This is a problem. I need to get with the dragon and get some real good guidance here.
We don't have a dragon yet.
Yeah, that's a problem. I live in the dragon back home. Oh boy.
We're a bunch of scaly no dragon boys.
I don't know why you keep saying boys like that. It's very strange.
I don't say that. What are you talking about?
What?
Well, let's go into town and see who shows up.
Well, this one talks the most like a human, so you should go in.
Okay, yeah, human tongue. Oh, that's it. That's his new title. You're human tongue. I call you that because I can't remember your actual name.
You can't remember much, can you?
It's all my own titles. My name is exceedingly long.
And, Jobes, you go forth and try to get new titles by accompanying...
Loogie.
By accompanying Loogie and watching his back.
Yes, sir.
Don't talk too much, and if it looks like they're going to kill him, run away. He makes a great meat shield, I think.
I'm an excellent runner, sir.
And since he's new, I need you to go in there behind him to make sure that he stays alive.
Oh, that's great. That's exactly what I want to do.
And I'll be there to protect you.
Okay, so I got a single file.
So we got it. Just him's going in, and then we have our jobs.
Yeah? Wait. But you said we was following, but then only he's going? And, oh!
Onward!
Come on, little fellas. I take the rest of the kobolds, and we head into town.
Just like as we walk.
He's bigger than us, right? I mean, am I seeing this wrong? I can swear, I think I'm a little taller than he is.
Anyway.
Well, you travel for a bit. The sun's been good and down now, so it's probably, roughly 1 o'clock in the morning. Perfect time for Kobold to be traveling.
Nice and dark.
You emerge out of the wooded area into the area in which you believe you're supposed to be heading. Rutted track emerges from the woodland hillsides. You finally start, since you can see in the dark, catching a glimpse of Fandolin, the town in which you believe you're supposed to be taking stuff to.
I'm not quite sure.
The town consists of 40 or 50 simple log cabins. There's a stone wall around the outside of the town, kind of crumbling, has some vines on it and such. Not a whole lot of...
What class are you playing?
Ranger.
Not a whole lot really going on because it's nighttime. You see a couple candles in windows. Nice little path that leads up in. You got the map right here. I'll share with you. Seems to be a large building right there at the opening. Actually, you guys can see all this stuff. One second. There you go. Alrighty, I figured it out. So
now it's fully open.
Yeah. Well, you guys can pretty much see coming down the hillside. You can see the entire town. So heading into the town, you guys approach the outskirts right there. Wagon kind of stops for a minute.
You're coming from the north.
We're coming from the north up there.
Okay.
So it's approximately 1 o'clock in the morning, pitch black. It's a night of the new moon.
Good and dark.
So it's good and dark.
So what
do you think that, well, most humans usually sleep at this time.
If anybody asks, you're a halfling with a skin condition. Pretty sure that'll work.
So, does one of us remember the... I asked it between the 20 of us. Does anyone remember the name of the place we were supposed to drop this stuff off at?
I don't know.
Did anyone get the name of that from whatever Ryan's character's name was?
Oh, the son of the king? Oh, actually, was a prince?
Yes.
Where the princes are supposed to be princes?
Yes, that one. The one who rides the warthog.
He definitely knew.
Any of you reinforcements have that information?
Oh, one steps her from the back.
You know who else knew? Crackleback. That guy knew.
I remember the dwarf guy saying something about taking it to the provisions place. I think it was Martha's or Martin's.
Get back in line!
Brathens?
You know what else knew? Keep by the big fire. The last prince. He left.
I roll an intelligence check to see if I can remember.
It's definitely the provisions place. We should take it to the provisions place.
You stand there for a minute and think about it and realize that. You weren't even alive when that happened.
16 plus 2. Did I hear over here?
You overheard back in the days when you were merely a wagon pusher that there was that you guys were heading to Brathern's Provisions to drop this loot off.
We still don't have horses. We're just
they
just pushed the wagon.
There was horses, but somebody killed them.
We had horses, and they were delicious.
Unfortunately, nobody thought to bring provisions to feed the kobolds, so you had 20 kobolds, 2 horses.
Right.
You kind of do the math.
Works for me.
Now you have 20 kobolds.
Works for me.
20 kobolds does come out to about one horse. A small horse.
I think it was only a 2-day trip.
Right?
Bunch of hungry boys.
Why do you keep saying boys like
that? So, to the provisions place. In the cover of night, we shall find him in his bed and sleeping, and not murder him until he gives us all gold.
But then murder him.
Well, most likely, once we get all gold.
What if, just this one time though, we leave him alive so that later he gives more work and we get more gold even more?
Sounds an awful lot like human talk.
What did the king say?
All gold.
All gold. And all do we gold. Do we kill the guy after?
After gold.
So we do kill. That's
somebody
that's
said after we get the gold, we're supposed to kill him.
And eat him, right?
I think that was optional.
That's always implied.
It's implied, yeah. I definitely think it was implied.
We didn't have to wait around to eat him. We could just kill him and go if we had to.
Yeah, but here's the thing. If everyone's going to get a piece of the guy...
We have 16 more kobolds to feed, so yeah, we're going to have to eat him.
Either we have to get his body back, or they all come in right after he's dead and start biting.
Oh, what if once we get in there and we find him asleep and vulnerable, we could ask him if he knows of where more all gold is.
Yeah?
Then we go get that gold.
Okay.
That might be worth leaving him alive.
Ah. Yep, we need to build a good hoard.
Oh, never find a good dragon without a good hoard.
I mean, I'd raise one for an egg, but I'll die while it's still a baby, so what's the point?
Right.
For kobolds. How do I get Mage Armor to take?
Go to main, see the little magnifying glass by your AC.
Yes.
Click that. Change the armor to 3.
Okay. Miscellaneous bonus.
The magnifying glasses don't let man the magnifying glasses.
It's an armor thing, so the armor goes to 3.
Okay. What about my fighting style?
Which one did you take?
I wanted the archer one. I'm not sure where to put it in.
Okay. You can just modify your
okay. can do that.
Because that's just numbers, right?
Alrighty, yeah, so heading into town.
Heading into town.
Yeah, would just.
You come across the first large building. It's actually the.
Is this fighting style?
Wrathian Provisions.
Next to it. And just.
Wrathson?
Yeah. And just.
Barthens?
Archery.
Barthens.
We'll go with Barthens.
Okay. Well, that's a big place. Is that the place?
It's got a big sign. Nice big stable next to it.
We determined that none of us can read, actually, so it doesn't matter what it's called.
Yeah, we can't remember.
It's got a sign hanging out over the road that has a big, it's like a big bag. It has like a sword sticking out of it on one side, some grain sticking out on the other, and gold piled in front of it.
Is that the place? There's gold on the sign.
Stuff and gold, that's provisions.
Okay. This is the guy we're going to go ahead and kill and eat. No, wait. Get all the gold and take it from there. Let's go.
So... Well, you said I had to go.
He's going in.
Oh, yeah.
Then you're backing him up. Right. You're making sure he survives, and I'm watching you.
I'm backing him up.
So I walk up.
I can't breathe.
And I see if the door opens.
So we walk up in a line.
Yeah.
I don't know what we're doing here.
You guys walk up to the door in a line.
Pull
the button. There's a couple lanterns burning out front. You know.
Hey, fire.
Yeah,
Door says closed, but you can't read it.
We all have our little hoods up. Little cultists in the night.
Says open hours, dusk till dawn.
We are.
You know.
We can't read.
So just do the magnifying glasses.
Is the door open?
Yeah, yeah. Okay, you got it. Right.
You pull on the door and it is locked.
Oh man, it's like they knew it was coming. Anybody got any of those picky things? What are they called? You use them on locks.
Bam, 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 bam.
Kind of like a picking thing.
Loogie begins to pound on the door viciously.
Oh, boy.
You hear some movement inside.
Picky thing. I hand you my hand axe.
Huh? That's not going to fit in the lock tossed away. It's like it don't even listen. So are you again?
A minute or so later, you hear somebody kind of fussling with the door. Who is it?
Oh, boy.
Well, you came with your wagon. We got stuff in your wagon for you, and you're supposed to pay us.
Bring it back in the morning. We're closed.
Bang, 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 bang. We're here now, and we just want to get our stuff.
This ain't going
go.
Smooth. What?
Bring it back in the morning. We're closed.
If we leave it here, someone's going to take it.
So, at what point do we set the building on fire?
After all the gold.
I don't think he's going to give it.
You hear him kind of shuffling with the door again. And he unlatches it and kind of opens it up. Looks out.
We're down here.
Hi!
What are you?
Quiet. He's speaking.
We're the people that your buddy hired to come in here and bring your wagon. Because he said there was nobody else to do it. And we got 20 people you're supposed to pay.
I'm supposed to pay 20 people for bringing a wagon.
He said we all are supposed to get 10 gold.
And there's 20 of you.
That's right.
What turn around. It? Hey, everybody! Wave!
What'd you do? Move the entire orphanage? It's an older guy. Late 50s. You can tell, like, his glasses are, like, up on his head, so he's not even... Can't even
no,
see.
We're not orphans. We're, halflings.
I turn around and Draconic, I yell...
Take the cart to the back!
They start pushing the cart.
Very, pushy halflings.
I guess put it over in the stables. It'll be safe there for the night.
You're going, next to the large four-legged food!
In Draconic.
Yeah.
Stop back in the morning when we're open.
We'll get our gold then, right?
Yes, yes, I'll pay you then.
Because we wouldn't like
it. He slams the door shut and locks it. It's almost as if you woke him up.
I don't know.
By pounding on the door.
I don't trust this guy.
Well, we're not here to trust him. Just take gold.
Why don't we sleep in the bar?
Yeah, I guess.
When the sun comes up, we'll wake him up.
I bet there are some nice juicy rats in there. Let us go partake. I will cook with my finger guns.
And finger gun effects.
Note to self, learn after effects.
Your soul kind of gets chilled a little bit from that because, you know.
Former life, your head exploded.
In a former guns. Life, you feel like something bad happened.
Former overlapping life. Yes. Anyway.
Indeed.
So we go into the barn.
Yeah, it wasn't even that long ago.
It was for kobolds.
So at least five seasons in kobold years. Alright.
So that happens.
I guess, alright, you 16 stay here, and you watch the cart. Make sure no...
I thought we were taking it to the barn.
We are.
Okay.
You stay here and watch the cart, and eat rats or something.
That's probably enough to catch a few rats.
Well, I think the four of us should go and look around town, make sure there's no gold laying around.
Okay, that seems like a good plan to me. Also, I'm obligated to do what you say.
Now you're obligated to listen.
At least until it's inconvenient. Well, I think I can do it better. It will be in the moment when you least expect it.
We're going to go where Jobs takes us.
Why, that guy? He didn't even have a name until yesterday.
None of us know the town either.
Oh, yeah.
Plausible deniability.
What's the worst that could happen?
And if he screws it up, then he has no titles.
Yeah. That means he gets executed right away. No trial at all.
That would be the worst.
I don't know. I get to watch an execution. That seems pretty cool.
Okay, so... Wandering Jobs, where do you wander to?
Single file.
Oh, yeah. What won't get me killed here?
Single file, 2 feet apart. Clang, 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 clang. Oh, so yeah.
19 AC.
Roll an intelligence check.
I actually closed it at one point.
No, it's at the bottom down there.
Oh, I moved it at some point. There we go.
Throw me up an intelligence check real quick.
Who?
Intelligence.
No. The one in charge now.
That's a save.
Intelligence.
The little die beside... No, that's the save.
All right, so...
We're still alive.
Yeah, that. There you go.
We'll go with the first one.
Oh.
Yeah, I roll a 2.
Hey, wait a second.
So... You actually. I'll let you keep the 20 because
that was his 20.
Yeah.
Oh well, then yeah, you did blow that.
Yeah, I
rolled a 2.
Yeah, so
I like to roll for fun though sometimes. Let me get that one out of there. Lion shield. There's another 2.
Probably about right.
Take care of it. The Shrine of Luck. Yeah, that looks like a good place to go to.
The Shrine of Luck, huh?
Yeah.
Why do you have pins?
Because I don't know how to turn them off for you.
No, I don't have them. He does.
I do, too.
I have them.
I'm the only one that doesn't.
You're the weird one.
I don't know where.
Weird. Weird Jimmy Patchy Face.
Okay. You're the one that's set up right.
You wander through town a little bit. Yeah, I don't know why. I don't get it. I blame Larry.
Can you click on him? Can you click on the pins?
Why? If you float over him, it tells you what it is.
I know why.
because I opened the book for in the modules.
Yeah, me too.
You don't need that open.
Except we have pins, and you
can I turn the pins off?
Well, yeah, you need to go into your modules in your library.
Well, the pins tell us the names of the buildings.
Which we're not
why shouldn't
to
we
know
the name of the building?
We shouldn't know that
because we can't read or write.
All right, so Lost Minds. Let me close that book.
How do I turn that
but
off?
I mean, we have to know our surroundings.
Go into the library.
Oh, boy.
Oh yeah, you can just share it.
Library.
All right, so
modules. Modules.
Take the green check mark out of it. Make it a red X.
Okay. Find Lost Minds of Andover. There you go. And drag that red X up onto it.
Like that.
Yep.
So give that, 20 seconds to update and then.
Hey, I didn't know. I liked it the way it was set.
Now you know.
I closed my map. Go ahead and close your map out and let them reshare it and see what happens.
Hello, yeah. Anna!
Alright. I still got pins.
Fuck it. Never mind then.
I also have pins!
You guys probably.
Oh, I can't open the pins anymore.
There you go.
Complains about module. Yeah.
That was the answer, but you have to. Get the nuke your cache next time you log in.
Yeah, that's probably.
I don't know.
The pins don't hurt me at all.
Well, regardless.
Yeah, they're fine.
You wander through the town into the town square and you find the Shrine of Luck, which you don't know it's the Shrine of Luck because you can't read!
Yes.
But it seems to be the only temple in town. It's a small shrine made of stones.
Yes, we should stop here and pray to we find our dragon soon.
Oh, we gotta pray to. We normally play a pray to a dragon.
Colonel Mac.
That guy? I don't know.
Not Crackle Mac. Curtle Mac.
Oh.
You know.
Yeah.
Kobold.
It's not the same, you know?
Baby.
For one thing, he's so big, he's got a lot of guys. You know, I'm an acolyte. I'm the only acolyte of a dragon. That's awesome. Big fish, tiny pond. But Colonel Mac? Yeah, I don't
know. But we don't have a dragon yet. So that's all we got.
He's not going to listen to us.
Well, dragons don't listen very often either.
It seems to be amazing.
They say
good
job and then smack you across the road. That's something.
This should be a bowstring place, you know.
Yeah. Look where all the people are. This town's terrible.
Well, keep an eye out for, gold laying around and things that we can make for the offerings.
Do humans leave gold on the ground?
Well, I think they usually leave them in boxes and things on these shrines. Let's go find out.
Oh, that's a good idea, yes.
Let's raid the shrine. It's not our god.
I got a crowbar.
All right, that looks like an excellent crowbar. Is that iron?
Well, it's it's just a small shrine made of stones taken by the nearby ruins. So, there's not really a...
No.
I gotta break open a door.
There are offerings?
There are offerings.
Ah!
Maybe there's something mixed in between the stones. Offerings? Too, because they stagger the stones.
We're destroying the altar.
Huh?
We're gonna destroy the altar to look for coins.
Yeah! I mean, it's not our god!
But, if we piss off the humans, they might not pay us.
How they know it was us? Nobody out here. They're all sleeping. Oh, it's nighttime, and there's no light. Oh, this is the time for sleep because I'm a stupid human. Who cares?
I can't fault that logic.
Fee.
Alrighty, so there is... Scattered around... You find 140 copper.
Oh, yeah. Well, metal coins are metal coins. That's something, right?
Absolutely.
It'll just be the bottom layer, and then the silver, and then the gold on top.
It makes the hoard look bigger.
It does.
We'll add that to
I mean, why would the dragon not like it? It's not like it's eating the gold. It's not like, well, it tastes bad. I am a dragon.
I put it into the party sheet for you guys.
All right. That looks awesome.
All right.
So, it's a start.
Let's see. What do we got in the bag? Yeah, there's a couple of gold. Yeah, a good amount of silver. And, oh, boy. I can barely pick up this bag of copper.
That's okay. We can take it back to the... we're leaving the cart.
That's like 700 freaking copper, man. Not that I know what numbers are, because I can't read.
Well, why don't we tell him we're supposed to take the cart back after he takes the stuff off?
Well, here's the thing. We're going to kill him, eat him, and take his cart. So, you know, when you get right down to it, I don't think it matters.
Well, I think the bigger buildings will have more money. Let's go check them out.
Oh, then they will know it was us if they wake up, though.
Suggesting we just go back and nap?
I don't know, maybe.
Very well, let's go back and nap.
I notice there's a... just off the side, there's a large building that has a sign on it that has, you know, big fluffy beds kind of showing off on it, and a plate of food, and you can see, you know, it has the chiseled steam coming off the food.
Hey!
Which, you know, kind of makes you go, that's not really anything interesting, is it?
It's a place. It's a place like what the humans go to, and they give the money, and they sleep there.
So you want to go to a place where there's a bunch of humans sleeping? The blue building across
from the.
They definitely have a bunch of gold in there.
Yeah, that's kind of what I was thinking. I was looking at this map, going, "A couple really big buildings might have."
You even hear you actually hear some ruckus coming from down from further down there, down that street there.
Okay.
Maybe so like, you know, out. Somebody's scuffling.
Ooh.
Having a,
we like fights.
You're not really sure what they're saying because you can't really hear. You hear some screaming. And, ah!
Hey, once they wear each other down, then we can kill them both.
Well, yeah, there's that. But what I'm thinking is...
I head out to the noise.
We get all the gold, you know, kill the guy, eat him, make sure that it's all secured, and then we ransack the town.
Yogi starts heading down the street in front of you guys.
Hey, didn't we have four guys?
Hey, you're supposed to watch him. Get over there.
All right. Run behind him.
Wait up.
Make sure he's alive.
But I don't care if he dies. Clang, 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 clang.
Single file. Single file.
It hides our numbers.
But does it really?
You travel down the street a little bit. You see a... Yeah. You trot. You have your trotting?
Sure.
Okay.
That's a word.
And you're smashed by a cart.
It's okay, it only did 10. I got 14 hit points because I went up a level. Woo!
They back up and sure get.
I'm not damaged at all, yay! This isn't China. People don't run you over and over again just because they don't want to pay for your medical bills.
That's a thing. Anyway.
Well, you approach what seems to be a glorious tap house in the dirty, marvelous side of town. Things just seem to be getting better. What you can, it seems to be there was a small scuffle outside. There's a guy leaning against the side of the building. You're not sure if he's dead, alive, or just sleeping.
Oh, he's a good one to take out, right?
Bleeding at all?
He looks definitely drunk.
I think we could dig him.
At this distance, you can't really tell because he's kind of slumped over.
Okay, so we need to do it real quiet, right?
Let's go see if he has all the gold.
Tiptoe. So, we all get over there. I'll step forward.
Like, hey, buddy, you doing okay there?
In Draconic or Common?
Common. I say in Draconic emphasis in Draconic. Although, if we're speaking to each other, I suppose it would be...
Clang. Clang. Clang.
Suppose
shut up! Clang. Clang.
I rolled a 1901.
pat the drunk on the cheek, though.
He just kind of shakes it off a little bit and goes back to his drooling.
Okay. I cast prestidigitation. It says boot on fire.
Who's with prestidigitation? Okay. I was going to just ruffle through his pockets and take his stuff.
He kicks at his boot for a moment and then just continues to sleep as it goes. He is really drunk.
Hey, let's drag him into an alley so nobody sees him.
Alright, so 18 sleight of hand to just ruffle through his stuff.
You begin to ruffle through his stuff. Doesn't seem to be a whole lot there. You find some of this like several different like papers with writing on them.
Papers. I don't know what this says. Crumple it up and throw it away.
Hey, hold on to that. Because we probably want to burn the body after, and paper burns so good to start things.
Ooh. Fire starter. All right, I'll keep it.
You find a small change purse.
Oh, look inside.
Inside of it is, we'll say, a silver and a couple copper.
Aha! Success!
More for the hoard.
Exactly. Yeah, right in the party sheet.
I did the party sheet.
Okay, so you're strong.
I'm pretty strong, yes.
I think you're stronger than me. Let's try and drag him in the alley, and then get him real quick, and do everything else we know to do. Yeah?
We have is all gold.
We don't have to kill him?
Wait, I thought we were going to eat the other guy.
I'm hungry now, though.
Well, if we're going to kill him, who's doing this in the middle of the street?
Yeah.
If we're going to kill him and eat him, we need to drag him back to the cart so all the other scaly boys can eat.
Makes sense.
Scaly boy? Yeah.
Everyone, grab an arm.
Right. There's four of us.
I'm going to take the left arm because I'm not the strong one.
And we just walk right through the middle of town.
You start to drag him off, and a female dwarf steps outside. What are you doing with him?
We're taking him home. It's okay.
It's okay. He's a doctor.
It's true. I am sadly a doctor.
He's staying here.
It's okay. He is a doctor.
I think my deception may have sort of made her think that he's not. And you're thinking of somebody else.
Oh,
Okay, bye.
Just trying to go with him.
Oh well, yeah. No, she believes you.
Yeah.
But he is a doctor.
Good old shitty inside roll.
Not only does she believe you're the doctor.
I am. It's a title of the part. I got two doctor titles. One's better than the other one.
She pretty much believes everything you say over the next 5 minutes.
You look good with your head on fire.
I'll have to look into that. That sounds fabulous.
It does look pretty good. Ow! Ow!
Did we, I don't know, turn the corner or something?
Yeah. Okay, you guys drag the drunk off.
For the eating.
Yep. Okay, I'll use kobolds.
Like, we're back in the game. It's not cannibalism because we're not
eating. Everybody stop at the same time, and he will definitely be here. With nobody having to deal with the fight back, okay?
So right, I'm going
to
let you read the back.
Stab!
And now you're just having fun with it, and I'm okay with it.
Morning start of the head.
Yep.
So, I mean, it's a minimum of, you know, 20, probably 30 damage, really. That's some of the strength bonuses.
Yeah, so but there's a lot of them have negatives.
Yeah. Well, excuse me, strength bonuses, and I have a dex bonus, too. I have I do a d4 plus 3 because of it. So, yeah, he's, like, super dead.
Well, you're dragging him off.
Oh, we haven't gotten back yet? Okay.
Okay.
Just a moment. Let me give this guy somewhat of a chance.
We got excited.
Okay, that's how it works. Got it.
Hey, I want to eat the heart, okay? Because we got away because I fooled that lady.
Oh. Okay, then.
The heart's the good stuff. Especially when it's properly cooked. You got to shoot the finger guns up in the tubes of the heart, and it cooks it from the inside.
So, you guys have turned the corner. You're about... You're just past the nice inn. Actually, you probably cut through the grass, right?
Sure. Whatever the shortest path is.
Yeah, you guys walk down the street enough to where, like, she's not watching. You guys jet off into the grass between houses. So you're right there in the field between the nice... Right there in the middle of the triangle next to the barns. Almost there.
Next to the barns.
Let's see.
Where are we?
Bottom of the map.
Right here.
I see nothing.
Nothing!
You see now?
There's a spot, yes.
Scribble spot?
Scribbled.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Scribble spot?
Where?
It's,
Oh!
The center, yeah, up and to the right.
There!
Up and the right. I see.
Oh, okay, right, so I can actually erase it.
Did we come from the north? Is that what we did?
Yes, we came in from the north.
Ah, okay, that's it. I thought we came up from the south, and that was confusing me.
The scribble is gone.
Okay. So, yes?
So, you're about right there. Oh, that's wrong.
Okay.
There.
That's nice right. Long arrow there.
Hey, I'm learning. Okay.
Draw a circle.
Okay.
Yes. There you go.
So, we're in a field behind those buildings.
Yes. So he starts to come to, only because you know he rolled a 20.
Mm. That is a thing.
And
what are you guys doing? Don't worry about it, buddy. We're gonna take you back to your place, man.
No, I need to finish drinking.
Yeah, you're pretty done, man. All the drink is gone. No part of the town.
The drink is never gone.
I have a tab.
I was the great son of the great daughter of the great whatever.
Hey, you're thinking of something else, I say with a 23. Or 22.
So tell me, Pelican, where can we find some gold?
While the conversation's going on, of course, we're still running with him.
he's fighting your drag, so make a strength check.
I guess it would just be the strongest person with advantage?
Yes.
Yes? Okay.
Yeah,
so not me.
I has a 13.
I figure we just do it as a group since we're all four doing it. These two of us have to succeed.
Is that how?
I rolled a natural 20.
I think that settles it.
So he's still going. He's definitely fighting you. So you guys, you're moving at half speed. But still moving.
Man, I can see why your wife left you. You're a jerk.
My wife didn't leave me.
You got a lot of catching up to do, man.
Do you know who I am?
Yeah, you're the drunk guy we're going to eat alive.
What?
Oh, no.
Wait. Excuse me, Phil. Do you know where there's some gold?
Yeah.
Oh.
Everybody can find gold. They have all kinds of down at the Miners Exchange. You can just go there and buy it.
Miners Exchange? What, yeah. The next sell children?
Yeah.
No.
Silly fool. They sell them people.
Quit dragging me.
Oh, he must be talking about miners, not miners.
Oh, miners, not miners. Let's get this guy back so we can eat him, huh?
Exactly.
Hold on there.
Okay, he's going to contest the fact that you guys are dragging him and want to eat him now. So,
wait, he's had a bunch of gold.
So yeah. Where's this miners exchange?
It's down at the other end of town.
Oh.
Well.
I knew I should have eaten some rats.
You Maybe he should show us the way.
Show us where that's at and we'll not eat you.
Ah, man!
It's just...
I'm so sad still, though.
You walk through the center of town, continue going straight, it'll be on your left.
Go!
We're back. Actually, you should take us there.
You were trying to whip him on.
Let Morty start. Whack! Got this small back. Bam! Bam! Go! Show us!
He begins to stumble back towards the inn.
You drunk boy!
Huh? I'll tell you.
No, I thought you saying that word wrong.
Think they're doing?
Well, they're not even open till the morning.
You still need to know where it is.
He stumbles, and his face stumbling is much slower. I get you guys about to. It takes probably about 10 minutes to get across town. And town's not that big.
Okay.
All gold is important.
He gets to the corner, and the Miners Exchange is one building kind of on a side road there. And he points it out. He goes, it's right there, but they're closed till morning.
That building right there.
Yes, that building right there.
Oh, the one with the picky thing on the sign.
Yes.
Oh, that's what that is.
The Miners Exchange.
Now we know where it is. Now we can take it back and eat it.
Ah! All right. Here we go.
All right. Back we go.
You guys attempt to grab him or something at this point?
Go! Go!
Okay.
We'll probably have to kill him and take him back.
I think so.
Yeah. Yeah, that's definitely going to be something that probably happens.
Just one drunk guy in a small town. No one will notice.
And this?
No, we've got to do initiative and all that before you can...
Okay. Yeah, we got to have pictures. I can't shoot him because he's not there.
Is this even going to function as a map? A proper map?
No, I'm not going to put this in as a proper
picture
map.
For me?
No. I sent it to Kevin so he could load it in. Oh.
Okay.
Yeah.
I'll take care of that.
That's all I got right now.
It'll
okay,
happen.
So.
Be the super pasty guy.
And he goes last.
Until then.
How about that?
I'm that guy.
So open your combat tracker.
I was adopted.
Okay, there we go. Yeah.
So. I'm not going to bother throwing up a map because this won't last very long.
So the question is, can I target...
Okay, so I go first.
Yeah, you can target straight from the...
Nice. Why does Jobes have a person face?
Because we haven't loaded his picture
yet. I was adopted.
Oh, God, no. Are you kidding
so
me?
So first up is Lugi.
And how do I target?
Shift and then click him in the combat
tracker. Control.
Or control.
Control.
Combat tracker. I don't see him in the combat tracker.
He's not in the combat tracker.
Oh, how do I make him feel?
Nope, he's not.
Hit the little eyeball. There you go.
There you go.
And then also and then it touch him. Targets. Got it? Yeah.
You still have yourself targeted. Control clip yourself.
Target, okay.
There you go.
There you go, yes.
Don't obey your wagon.
Cast. Attack and damage.
All right. Damage. He lived through that amazingly.
Get him, Jobes.
If he doesn't get a turn, he doesn't get to scream.
Earn your word.
Jobes, is it my turn?
Is he yep.
Finishes? All right. I don't see where it says it's my turn.
He's a ranger.
A ranger. There he goes. Ah, that's what I was looking for.
I'm learning.
Yep.
That also wasn't your turn.
Yeah.
You got it.
All right. Let's see.
He begins to beg and plead for his life. I have children.
That's what we do.
To run or
yeah, why will take arrows?
He's close.
Close. All right, I'm gonna hand axe him then.
She moved to another town last night. You don't even got a wife.
Don't we have a bed?
And that's all it took.
Yeah, we didn't
miss.
It doesn't matter.
We
didn't
miss, so yeah.
I jump out with my hand axe and
my
mighty 1 point. Right in the neck.
Good job, Jobes.
Okay, So you come down on his neck, splattering blood everywhere. screaming your mighty screams.
Right.
Well, we don't want anyone else to know where this food's going. I grab a bunch of dirt and pack it in his neck. Stuff.
Hold on. Pull off his shirt and wrap it around his neck.
Like, real tight.
Real tight. Like, it doesn't matter. Just like bind it so he's not dripping anymore.
There's definitely a lot of blood on the ground.
Oh, yeah. Hold on. I burn it in the grass.
Press the vegetation.
And I'll burn the earth there.
Ah, it's scorched and cleaned.
Scorched earth, it's the way I fight and indeed.
It's the way of the fire dragon. But
yes!
Anyway, back to the clans so we can feed them.
A medicine roll? Okay.
That's fair.
You're trying to keep it from bleeding everywhere.
Ooh.
Ah, suck.
Well, you didn't save his life.
He bleeded out.
So it's definitely not bleeding as bad. There is definitely just blood rolling out of his carotid artery.
You guys carry him, and I'll clean up after.
So we three are carrying him, and he's walking behind with a bucket.
I've got the torso part. I'm sorry.
Press the digitation. Yeah. Press the digitation.
Alrighty, that happened.
That was hard. Kobolds in town. That's what happens.
This is gonna be a great roast. Ah, man, I can't wait. Ah, I wonder if there's any herbs and spices around the camp.
So,
yeah, it's a farm, right?
We'll take them back. Actually, yeah, we should put them on a spit and just roast them right behind those buildings.
That's a great idea. His torso and abdomen, they go on the spit.
Then we get our all gold in the morning. Then we can go and find the dragon, right?
Right. Ooh, miners, though.
Oh, right. We have to go there tonight, too.
Oh, yeah. We got to kill the miners and take their gold. Wait.
Well,
they just said it was a gold inside the building.
Oh, yeah.
So we just get inside and take all gold.
But it's not coins, is it? I mean, if it's been mined, just mined, it don't come out of the mountain.
When's the last time the dragon doesn't care? Gold is gold.
Okay, man.
It's hoard gold. Okay, hoard gold!
Hoard gold!
You guys are carrying a body back through the center of town.
Absolutely. At 2 in the morning.
At 2 in the morning.
Because we're kobolds.
So nobody's going to notice this guy, right? Being gone?
There's
Nah.
Of course not.
He doesn't look important.
Okay. Well, I always thought of myself as kind of a prophet, you know, because I'm the acolyte speaker of the dragon and stuff. And it's like, I figured I must have been right that his wife left town and his kids are gone. Right? Because I'm like a prophet.
Yep, that just works for me.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that's what's missing. Speaker of the dragon. For my list of titles.
Yes.
Well, I guess there's not really a dragon anymore. It's a corpse. It's probably rotted a little bit too much. To look like
former
a dragon.
Speaker of the dragon.
Yeah.
Maybe future.
Well, he's got to speak for the dragon because the dragon can't speak for himself.
Those two.
No, I'm behind cleaning
up. Right. These two are in front because I'm carrying the torso.
Check.
We are each carrying a leg.
Yeah.
Perception. Not great. So. Oh, but I rolled really high.
Yeah.
Perception check, so we're doing?
Just, he's in front, you kind of have a leg in your.
Okay.
Well. Oh, yeah. Fine. Okay, yeah, whatever.
I guess. Are you guys carrying him leg first or what?
Well, yeah, I think we each had a leg and he was carrying the rest.
Go ahead and give me a perception as well.
Excuse. Perception.
Two high rolls.
Nice.
21.
Big dice. Right.
Okay, so as you're walking through the center of town, you notice what looks to be a young woman over at the shrine.
I shout over, "Don't bother, we already checked it!"
Don't bother, don't mind us! We're just leprechauns! Working with your imagination! Bye!
It's okay, he's a doctor!
It's true, I'm totally not!
There should be a party that Richard is trying to kill us right now.
No, it has to go on long enough to where the town will send out for help. And it's like when the adventurers arrive, we've been having problems with these kobolds for X number of days now.
They've left town. Go track them down.
Yeah.
Get us our all gold back.
All right. Sorry. That was something.
You can't bring the people back, so bring back our all gold.
Why don't we all re-sing it now? Because that's what they kept saying. You called all the girls boys.
Boys?
The fuck is that? That's fucking weird, man.
It's a twitch before.
Okay.
Look, we're going to have to go through like 5 or 6 characters each in this. Yeah. Something to make it unique.
You have to go through 5 or 6 characters.
Oh, it'll be your turn.
No! Too cagey.
Happening of the wolves!
Okay. Yep.
We're doing stuff now?
Sort of.
Oh,
I mean, you guys are carrying a dead body through.
Yep.
So is she trying to
say
get
anything or is she trying to stop us?
Yes. She goes, "Oh my god, what have you done?"
"Nothing. I just taken this pile of wood back to our camp for burning."
I don't care what you want. It's not going to work.
Oh, come on. It's dark outside.
Should have went with the doctor. All right.
Well, you know what this means. Finger guns!
All right, lady, what's your problem?
She shot her.
The lady lets out a scream.
Oh, come on! I'm trying to ambush her so she can't scream.
Well, you can't ambush someone who's talking to you.
You also have a leg. You also have holding a leg.
I dropped it.
Which gives her a chance to scream.
Yes.
Never mind.
It's because you were holding a leg.
You actually
finger guns, people in the air.
It's not the sign above the inn. Here, actually, I'll roll for it and see. 15 plus. Okay, you shot the sign above the inn, causing it to cling to the ground in a loud burst of energy.
Uh oh.
So, I'm thinking we run.
Oh.
I don't know. I just follow him.
And we're gone.
Well, before you can run, roll initiative.
No, you roll initiative.
But that's what happens.
That's right, you roll our initiative. Then you can set the thing back to the first round, or just scroll it down to the...
We never made it out of the first round anyway.
Yeah. So. There. Show the bad guy, whoever that is. There. That works.
She's a villain.
Nothing.
She's not a villain.
Duh, she is.
What?
She's an antagonist. And we are protagonists.
So the obviously dressed sister.
Oh, it's in there. It just goes off the edge for me.
We don't know that.
Decides that, you know, you guys are obviously evildoers.
Oh, obviously. I mean, really, obviously.
Hey, we think we're doing a great job.
Well, yeah.
Just trying to get all your perspective.
I will play that perspective, but out of character. Yeah.
Yeah. We're just trying to get all gold for new dragon.
We have to feed our giant clutch of kobolds waiting for us.
God.
Let's see, so how do I make this attack?
I don't think they have a chance to attack us yet, do they?
Nope, I haven't made it to my turn to actually attack yet once, so now I get to
So click where it says, see where it says round 3?
Yeah.
Click the 3 and hit 1 and then enter. That should reset everybody's stuff.
Yeah. So then it starts with her turn.
So you should, yeah, be able to expand her stuff out with all those little buttons across the side.
Yeah.
And then under there should be her attacks and weapons and whatnot.
And spells and...
Yeah.
Okay, so that's her target. How do I make the attack roll with hers?
You can, if it's a weapon attack, there's the, you see the die code where it says D20 plus whatever?
No.
Did you check all, or expand out all the little things next to, across her, hard to describe without looking at it.
So yeah, right there, you got actions.
Yeah.
That's what she can do, there might be more below there.
It doesn't give me an option to do them. Last guy you killed.
No, I'm saying, see where it's covered and it's blue?
Yeah.
You can double click that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like that. Ah, you attack me!
With the 20.
That hits me! Damn it!
Using what?
A rock.
Oh, wow.
I drop his torso on the ground.
He doesn't know this.
Okay, that moves on to the next person. She yells something like, "You foul beast," and throws a rock at you.
Quang.
Okay.
Hi.
Loogie, what are you doing?
I'm running.
You're running? All right. Well, then move your thing down the next turn.
Run like hell. Run like
double hell. Double running.
Turn complete.
So on the combat tracker, bottom left corner, there's a little dragon with a down arrow. There you go.
Also running.
Too many times. Someone did it twice.
No. It was my turn. I said also running.
Oh, okay.
Marv.
60 feet movement. I don't know how long it's going to take because we don't have actual icons. I
really want to go murder.
You're a kobold, though. You're not like a dragonborn or some other valorous creature.
Yeah, but she hit me with a rock.
That's true.
Well, you're the leader. You haven't told us what to do. So we're doing what comes naturally.
I'll look at her and go, and then run away.
All right. Well, I was told to follow him. I run. We've lost our body.
Move and dash, move and dash, move and dash, move and dash.
Here we go.
It's okay. There's too many of rats back in that barn.
You guys run through the wherevers.
Let's
he gives chase for a short moment. And
let's loop around so they don't know which direction we're going.
Yep. You don't seem... You guys seem to have lost... Head lost her.
He literally went 5-0 scatter. He's like hands on my knees when we finally get stopped. Hey, stop it, humans. They're gonna bury our head body. All that good meat just going in the dirt.
That is a complete waste.
That guy had just the right amount of fatty marbling. I could tell when I was carrying his thigh.
Would have been a tasty boy.
Yeah, that's shot of there.
Alrighty, so that's taken some time. Where'd you guys scatter to?
I guess we'll just return to the clutch.
Yes.
Yep.
But we looped around.
We know there's a miners exchange that we can get all gold from later.
Yes.
We said, why don't we send the clutch out so that they think it's them that did it?
They got the wagon.
We'll guard the wagon, and we'll send them running around, and they'll chase them away and leave the gold exchange alone.
Mm-hmm. Well,
exchange.
A distraction.
The miners exchange.
It's not too far away from the morning sunrise now.
You four, go back to the chief and get real reinforcements. I sent four of them out to get reinforcements.
Okay. Oh, man. I'm hungry. I was really going to enjoy the hell out of that man flesh.
You smell that?
What?
That's horse.
Oh, yeah.
Gotta be careful, though. We don't have all gold yet. And, you know, they might not like it if we eat their horses.
It's true.
Yeah, no, that's kind of like you should have thought about that before we killed the guy to eat him. They probably like us less if we eat one of their own than if we eat one of their horses.
Ah, there wasn't none. That guy was gone. This guy don't know that guy. He don't know.
You hear commotions coming from the town square. There's a bunch of torches.
So we should, since the sun's coming up, probably get our gold now, right?
Yeah, he's probably open now, right?
Yeah, sure.
Open! Look, there's the same building with the back door. like at our chief's cave. He has a back... I don't know.
Go on, Logie, go up there with your weird baritone voice that no Kobold should ever have. You do that and you tell a guy we want our gold. You're a man, Logie. I believe in you.
Why do I think that you're going to be running as soon as I hit that door?
I don't know why you think that.
He won't run because he's going to stay there and watch over him.
And I got to stay there and watch you.
So I go up. They knock on the
door. In a line.
I try the door to see if it's open.
The door is actually open.
We come in.
You walk in. There's there seems to be a younger guy kind of just straightening stuff up on the shelves. And then the old guy you talked to before is over behind the counter.
Hello there. You said to come back and we're here.
Yeah, I'm sorry. There's been a lot going on. I don't know what's happened, but... And he's got his glasses up on his head. And it started to rain.
And then when he's done...
He goes... somebody killed one of my clerks last night. And...
How terrible!
What's a clerk?
It's a like cleric, a man. He just don't know how to talk.
Oh, the other, okay, all right. I understand.
Yeah, it was the other guy who helped take care of the shop.
Right.
And he also usually handled all of our large transactions for the wagons and such. So it's taking me a little bit to try to figure out exactly.
It's from a dwarf. We got a job from a dwarf.
Do you happen to know his name?
It's,
Rocky?
No, be quiet.
Wasn't there a paper in the wagon?
It was a G word. It was a G sound.
Do you have the the inventory from the wagon? Should have been an envelope, put on the inside.
Oh, okay, I go get
run to the wagon.
What's an envelope?
Folded paper.
Paper. Fold it over, and I think they lick it.
Okay.
Oh, is this reception?
Sometimes they write on it.
There's a 70% chance somebody found it, saw it had words, and threw it away.
It's like a container for letters.
On 11, you find the envelope.
Oh, okay. Running back. Not even investigating, it was inside.
You come back in?
Yeah.
I have the papers!
He takes the paper.
It's a folded paper thing, see, that's what envelopes are.
Goes, hey Thistle, come check the inventory. And he hands it off to the other guy who goes out and paying absolutely no attention to you guys. Just takes it and walks out the door.
He should be fine.
Oh, yeah. No problem.
Wait. We told the other ones to guard the wagon. I run out and tell them not to attack this guy.
You are a ruiner.
I'll go.
You're supposed to fuck it up.
You run outside and you Thistle's pinned against the side of the wagon, bunch of kobolds shoving him up against the wall.
No, he's supposed to check it. Stand down.
But he doesn't have all gold.
We we can't get gold until after checks the wagon. Let him go.
They reluctantly release him, and he hesitantly starts checking the wagon, occasionally shaking a kobold off his leg.
I said, let him go. I press a digitate, a ball of fire.
Is that a thing?
I don't think it is.
I don't think it is either. I thought
if you can't do any damage with it.
Yeah.
It's just an illusion.
Yeah,
it would illusion. It would be a glowing warble.
And prestidigitation in fifth ed allows you to actually start a fire.
Yep. This is true. It's one of the things in the book.
All right. Not quite as effective as finger guns, but...
No.
Nope.
Nope.
That's because I got brain guns.
Anyway. So he does
the reading. Off, not our fingers.
Right, so he does the reading. And he's going to... A few moments later, did you head back inside and you stand out there watching?
Well, I'm watching because...
Okay. Because about once every 6 seconds, a kobold jumps on him, looking up at him,
and I say, let him go.
He finishes checking inventory. There seems to be, you know, some things missing, but he obviously can't tell. Because, you know...
He's nervous as fuck.
He does... Grr! Grr! No! You're out there tapped.
So, a couple moments later, this one comes bursting back in the door. I checked the wagon, but I really need to talk to you about this.
I guess we still have our hoods up and everything.
Was the papers not right? Because I got these papers here.
Sorry about that.
No, the papers were fine.
Sorry about our guard dogs.
Guard dogs.
I'll just leave the papers on the counter.
Yeah, they don't warm up to people on the first time you meet them, you know.
Guard dogs.
They have a skin condition. all their fur falls out. It's a flea allergy.
Sir, I really need to talk with you. And he kind of waves him away. Just stock the shelves. I don't care. Just go cut firewood, something. I'm not going back outside.
So, about our all gold.
Your payment.
Yes.
Correct?
Seven's about right for trying to convince someone that the group of kobolds is very close.
No, he is not convinced.
Not even a little bit.
Skin condition. Flea allergy. Mage? Liamily mage.
He kind of takes and rubs his eyes for a second, pulls his glasses down, starts looking over the paperwork.
Don't be racist, Matt.
And he goes, okay, so you guys came here with Gunder, huh?
Gundren, yes!
That's the guy!
I told you it was a guh sound.
Right.
Well, actually, somebody attacked him and killed something, and we had to rescue it from a...
Oh, yeah, we went to the... You guys went into the goblin caves.
Right.
Oh, yeah. He drops his glasses down around his neck and kind of rubs his eyes again and goes, what happened to Gundren?
He sent us. He didn't come with us. He sent us.
He never said he wanted to come with us, man.
Well, he said he was going to be coming ahead.
Well.
Did he not show up?
I'm guessing not.
We had to take the wagon from some goblins.
Yeah.
Maybe the goblins got him.
The wagon's got goblin arrows sticking out of it still, man.
I haven't seen the wagon. I'm surprised a couple short fellows like you were able to defend against some goblins.
Hey, now.
We're pretty crafty.
Well.
Goblins burn just as easy as everybody else. I mean.
Crafty boys.
Oh, I mean, I understand that that's true.
We were a bit out of the realm. There's nowhere we could set traps for them, but we took... Went into their cave and took them and did down.
There was a bugbear, and I set him on fire,
And then his wolves almost killed me.
Were you able to find Gundren?
Hey, we found some bones that had been chewed on some.
Oh, there was that tied up person.
Yeah, that was the human guy, and he got eaten by the wolves too.
He did?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, he came up out of the water like, I'm going to kill you for leaving me in there. And like, well, they're sorry, but, you know, the wolves are going to kill us. Then the wolves that were chasing us, they jumped on him.
That
he was in the water. What am I going to do?
That must have been when I was helping the prince leave.
Yeah.
No conversation. What's he do when something's going on like that?
What are they talking about? Well, Gunner was a good friend of mine, and I implore you to search him out and bring him back.
Oh, okay, there. Well, rewarded that.
Can try.
If there's more all gold involved.
Oh, I mean, I'm sure he would definitely pay you for saving his life.
You'll get paid gold for saving lives?
How many of do you say there were of you guys?
20.
That's an awful lot.
All fingers and all toes! Well, your fingers and toes, yes, fingers and toes!
Well, what does paper say what we should be paid?
Well, it says 10 gold a person.
Right.
For the stuff?
Oh. We cannot charge for dogs.
And we don't actually pay you for your dogs.
Oh. Then just 10 gold for us each.
That's a smaller hoard.
But we get to go look for Gundark and get more gold.
More work.
So he counts out the 40 gold, puts it in a nice little sack.
But they didn't believe about the dogs.
No, he didn't believe about the dogs. This guy never looked.
We got 20 guys and some dogs. Ooh. So, you know.
Let me see the sack. Put it the gold. It's a lot of gold.
I hand it over. I put it in the party.
Yep.
Okay,
we go get Gundren.
Where is he? You know where he is so we can go get him?
Well, it's a really good question.
Well, let me think. Last time we see him for sure, he gives us the wagon, and he rides away. Then we find horses, and we thought they was his, shot to death. And then we go to the caves.
Those horses must have been his horse.
Was they? Was it more than one horse, or was it just one horse?
I think there were two, but remember there was that human guy, too.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe that other horse was that wolf food's horse.
But why we never see the dwarf guy again?
We'll go. We gotta go and look there. That's where we'll go back to and see
what's going on. Well, I mean, When he would come into town, he would always stop by here first. We have been having some issues with the red brands.
What's a red brand?
Sounds like a goblin tribe name.
No, not so much goblins as just, you know, nasty people.
Bandits?
Bandits. Bandits a good one.
You don't like bandits, right?
No.
We're allowed to kill bandits.
Yeah.
And do whatever we want to them after?
Right, that we're allowed to. They said we could kill them.
Yeah, I mean, and there's, from what I understand, there's a reward for, you know, for killing those bandits.
Oh, yeah? More all gold.
Yeah, they would give you the, you know, all gold.
How we get reward?
Well, you just take those, they have an insignia you can take in and give to the, and turn in at the mayor's.
We don't even need to show the body?
Well, no, we don't want people bringing bodies back into town.
What do we have to bring?
That makes so much sense now.
What do we have to bring back?
That means we can have food and gold.
It's just something to show that, you know, they were a member of the gang.
Okay, so like a head?
we'd prefer something. I mean, that's not really my place. I mean, I'm sure they prefer just some type of insignia for the.
How about ears?
Sure.
Okay.
Intestines?
Yeah.
Let it go. Let it go. They just want the red the thing that they wear.
Insignia.
And we get all the other things for the clutch.
Insignia means
okay,
logo.
We go. We head out.
Okay, bye.
Where are red brands?
I stop at the door again.
Oh, wait a minute.
That was pretty important, didn't it?
Well, I heard they frequent the Sleeping Giant Tap House.
Where's that?
It's right across the field over there.
Oh.
You'll notice it. It's one of the seedier bars in town.
Is it back in the town, or is it that building way over in the east there that's separate from the town?
It's before that.
It's back in the town there. It's just down from the inn.
It's on the same road.
What is that building over there? It looks kind of run down.
It's the Trastendar Manor.
Oh, I totally forgot about that.
I bet that is where...
No one lives there?
The brand guys are. We should go and investigate.
Yeah, it's been abandoned for years.
We're out on the front porch. Meanwhile, in the background, back in the town, there's like, rabble!
Yeah. Like, it's too bright.
It started to rain.
Oh. It's still too bright!
keep your hood forward, man. It'll be fine. Do some squinting.
There you go. If we head back...
You hear the guy from inside. Damn it, that's what... Go unload the wagon!
But the yappy scale dogs are trying to bite me!
So, we should... We have the all gold from the wagon.
Yes.
So, let's get the clutch away from the wagon. Let them take stuff.
Okay.
Because stuff is not for Horde. All gold is for Horde.
Yes.
Okay. I need your whipping whip then for the whipping of them. I get that.
Morningstar!
Thank you!
Run out.
Go.
Get away from them! Leave the humans alone! Bad! Bad! Just whacking them on like the base of their tails.
This is why we need more reinforcements, because we're going to accidentally kill them. So we tell them to go wait north of town because of reasons.
Sure, north of town.
Because of Kobold reasons.
Into town. That sounds great.
Alright.
Well, that's the closest road to where we are.
You think you're gunning at their feet as they go? Get when hungry, get food from fields.
Mice, birds,
cows.
Oh, yeah, cows are a lot of meat. They're just always standing out there alone. I don't know why nobody, I don't know how they don't get eaten more.
Really, really thick skin.
It's kind of tough, but when you peel it off, everything underneath is great.
All right, you guys have set the clutch off to the fields and...
Yep.
It's 8 o'clock.
To do kobold, evil kobold-y stuff to the farm fields. Because that's what they should be doing.
The grasses are probably 3 feet tall, so they can't be seen.
Wiggly grasses.
Yeah. All right. So next
week,
you
see a horse head on a stick.
So we're skipping the stupid bar and going to the big house. Is that what we said we're gonna do?
Well,
we can do the bar.
Out of character.
That's what I'm saying, yeah.
Need to get the fuck away from the town for a while.
Well.
Because we were just caught in a murder attempted cannibalism.
The paperwork I was trying to hand the guy was the paperwork from the dead guy.
Yeah.
She wouldn't take, thank you.
Yeah, as we're walking. So I'm thinking, that crazy lady back at the shrine? Maybe we should kill her, So we can go back into town without someone being able to say, hey, it's those
too
guys.
Late. Too late. We'll just go.
So the chemical prepper, we...
Nobody else saw us.
We're going to that big house, right?
Yeah.
The big empty house?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, it's a good place for us to hang out because it's abandoned.
Right. Abandoned.
Yes.
Hypothetically.
Yes, because hypothetically, nothing
what he
bad
said.
Ever happens in an
abandoned
house.
It's a giant abandoned house. It's perfect for us because there's
probably
going to hide somewhere.
It's probably not full of vampires and shit.
Most likely not.
Yeah, not vampires.
So that'll do it for this Carpe Diem Kobolds.
Yep, yes. That'll be it for this this session of Carpe Diem Kobolds. I learned a lot about Fantasy Grounds, and I look forward into doing better with it next week.
Anything better.
Two weeks from now.
Two weeks.
Again,
we'll be building some content in our offline game due to venue issues.
See on YouTube.
Yep. Catch up to those on YouTube and
Strahd and
we will Death House. Continue again 2 weeks from today.
Yep. All right. 2 days.
Easter Sunday.
When's that? 2 weeks.
2 weeks from today.
2 weeks from today. That so the 16th is Easter.
Yes.
Yeah.
Who's going to be there for that?
That may be a problem. All right. That's so maybe 3 weeks.
So maybe 3 weeks.
Let's say 3 weeks.
Holy
cow.
We have some holidays that are going to affect. I can honestly say I'm not that religious, but my kids like chocolate, so...
Well, is Easter an all-day thing now? Damn. You guys want to stream your thing next Sunday?
No, we just record it.
No, it's way easier to record it than it is to try to deal with streaming.
Yeah. Two separate recordings are taking place, and then I'm splicing them.
Ah.
I'm recording the video, or the Fantasy Grounds stuff, and he's recording all the Google Chat stuff.
Mm-hmm. Gotcha. And then I have the window sliding and zooming in and out and shit.
Alrighty, so are we...
3 weeks.
3 weeks from now, then.
From now, we'll do this.
Alright, but check out Carpe GM 2, every weekday, basically, there's going to be something, some kind of marathon.
And check our YouTube channel, we'll make Moe's upload more stuff. So
every day, pretty
and
much.
And I will prep!
There you go.
Excellent!
So plenty of time to do so. I can do it while people are doing church things.
Thanks for watching.
Thank you very much.
This is Ohio.